any veteran today, what they'll tell you is they fight for the guy on their right and the guy on their left. And whatever reason they got into the Army in the first place, once they're actually facing combat, that's why they're fighting.
And if you ask any mercenary, they'll tell you they fight for money. I mean, that's the bottom line. No, no, it's not watering it down at all. The bottom line is if, yes, we've got, if you look at some set battle that we know a lot about, Agincourt just being a perfect example, why are those guys there? Why are they there? Is it because they've overcome fear? Do you think that those soldiers are not frightened when they see the French and how many there are and what they are doing? So what's motivating them there? Is it Henry V's grand speech in front of them? No, I mean, they're motivated because they have been paid, they are now enlisted, they're there, they do not leave because they have a responsibility. And I think that economics becomes a huge issue, that if we think that it doesn't, if we think that somehow somebody can get motivated to go out and face death, do you think Henry V really motivated somebody to say, yeah, I'm going to go get a spear in my groin? No. But they go home a little more wealthy.
But there is, I think for the early Middle Ages, I think the warfare is an activity which is associated with noble status. And I think it's, you know, you may have the whole of society involved, but in effect, the people who are putting themselves forward, I think it's, by definition, that's giving them that sense of nobility, it's giving them that sense of aristocracy. So I suppose it's those people who can push themselves forward who are doing that. And I think one of the great examples of the source about fear in the early Middle Ages is in the Anglo-Saxon Chronicle during the reign of Ethelred the Unready, at the beginning of the 11th century, where one of the local leaders in 1003 in Wiltshire apparently retched as if he's about to be sick, and so the army ran away. And you know, it's kind of presented that he's pretending to be sick and not be able to lead the army. But I mean, you just think of the fear that must be there for, you know, somebody who thinks I'm beyond my pay scale.
The three answers you've got essentially indicates that the question has to be answered in terms of context. Who is doing the fighting? What is the context of the fighting? And for example, if you're a noble or an aristocrat, that's one thing. If you're a poor guy fighting in defense of your local village, that's something else. If you're a mercenary, that's something else. And the nature of the battle, are you going across a killing ground with a 30-foot, 40-foot ladder, have to climb the ladder, and then fight at the top of the ladder with the people who are defending? That's yet another situation. So that context is absolutely essential to understanding everything that goes on in warfare.